to the grills with spears and fears. Creature from the Black Lagoon, Leonardo. Oh, shit. I was really nervous. Not nervous, but I don't know, iffy on getting this one. I didn't really care for the way he looked when I saw the box. And then after I saw a review on him, I was like, okay, all right, changed my mind. He's awesome looking, though. He's great. Well, we're going to dive right in, see what this bad boy is all about. Yeah, man. It's great. Had to grab a knife for this one. Leonardo is a creature from the Black Lagoon Ultimate Action Figure by NECA. There we go. I always love all the accessories, everything that they come with. They just make them look so good. The boxes are always hard for me to throw away, man, because they look so cool. You know? It's great. There we go. He's got a spear with a big old piranha on it. Look at that thing. It's massive, dude. And he's got interchangeable hands. Put this claw on one of them. Awesome. Another spear. The handle on it. His sword. Oh, yeah, this one does too. My bad. His hands look great, man. Wow. I never know how I want to pose them, you know, when I set them up. I always go off the box, and then I'll see somebody post a cool last picture of them, and I'm like, yeah, dude. Like I saw somebody from the movie line, Casey Jones, where he had both his the bats, and he was holding them like this. I was like, yep, that's why I have them set up like that in my room. NECA is notorious for that. They always hook you up. Get a little bag on the side. I didn't even see it. But yeah, before I throw away my boxes, I check everything to make sure I got everything out of there. Look at that, man. Some fishing line, looks like. With some hooks and bobbers and beautiful, man. I love it. Love it. Trying to see where you would put that. Dude, it looks great. I think I'm going to have him holding his swords. Dude, paint job is great. All right, so we're going to change out his hands. Do that real quick. Usually not too hard with these. Came right out. Bada bing, bada boom. Some of the figures, man, I had to heat up. Soak it under warm water. Like a Leatherhead's tail. couple other things. But I've seen people doing it and I'm like, man, that sucks. I've never had to do that with my fingers. And then I ran into that problem and I'm like, oh man, this is nerve-wracking. Dude, he looks great. I love the turtle that he came with too. Little turtle. Man, he's so like dark and gritty looking. Yeah, man, these hands are a little tricky to get them open. But I've been playing with toys since I was a little shithead, so I know how to get these things in. Now, the one problem I have with NECA, and I know a lot of people do, standing the figures up, especially like the female figures. They're terrible, dude. Their legs, like just how they make them, man. But that works, man. That works. Let's see if I can get this bad boy on.
Fix
Fixes
his
knee pads. Looks awesome, man. Love him. I'm glad I got him, dude.
That on there first.
There you go. Leonardo is a creature from the Black Lagoon by NECA. I freaking love it, man. Thank you. I actually got that one from Target.
See if we can get a closer view of him.
There you go. Love it, man. Hell yeah. Thank you for watching, guys. That's my review on Leonardo as a creature from the Black Lagoon. All right, we are back for another review. Yeah, Raphael is the Frankenstein monster. Ooh, beware of his shocking sigh. The first one that I got, the first Universal monster figure that I got, and man, I was hooked. Like I was hooked on how they looked. Woo, I might want to move closer. There
Hold
we
up.
go. Pure terror from the sewer. Yeah, man, let's check them out. Let's dive right in. This one looks great. This guy, I was not iffy on getting. And he was actually given to me by Orlando, a buddy of mine. And thank you. Thank you, dude. I love him. It's an awesome figure. There we go. Could not get that back part open. Let's see. Yep. The detail they put in these guys, man. Comes with two size, as usual. This one, I don't know, man. I might put his size in his little holders right here. 'Cause I like the hands that he's got on now. I like them.
they're all like, braids, braids. Yeah, I like that.
See, I gotta check that one, make sure there was no bag on the side, like the other one. Yeah, dude. Awesome. He looks great.
Brett.
Yeah, I don't know, man. It, like, the way that they have their figures stand, like their feet and their all the joints, it's like, it's cool that they add so many, dude. They're just, I feel like some of them are fragile, they're janky, and it works. The damn thing's alive. We're gonna put these bad boys right up front. Try to get those chains out of the way. You got like these Todd McFarlane chains going on here. That was always my favorite with his toys. All the Spawn figures. The chains that he added. It looks so badass. But so does this guy. Oh. See, it's always that first initial stand. Once I get him, I'll be alright. I noticed that too, man. Like, people were saying that their NECA figures are starting to fall, you know, because of the joints are starting to get weak and shit. I've never had that problem. Never had that problem. I'm sure I will. I'm sure. Look at that bad mamma jamma. Raphael as the Frankenstein monster. Love him, man. That is great. He's so detailed. See on his back right here, he's got the New York sewer cover on his shell. It's like stapled on his shell. Or bolted, I'm sorry. He's got the tubes on his neck and shit. Man, I love him. That's great. Hell yeah. Thank you guys for watching. Stay lifted. Welcome back for another review. Michelangelo as the Mummy. Oh yeah. This guy looks crazy, dude. He comes with two different heads and they both just look nuts. I don't know which one I want to put on there, but I'm sure Leppy will help me decide. Is it dead or alive? Michelangelo as the Mummy by NECA. This one comes with a lot of stuff. Beware the curse of the cowabunga, you've been warned. The party dude is out of his tomb. Mikey comes to life. No idea what these are. I think these go around his wrist, his hands. There's two of them. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's what they are. check this out. This is what I was like. I had no idea this was in there. This makes it even better, dude. That's going to take me a minute to get him to stand. I will get him to stand. It's a wire in there, so it's pretty easy. You just got to mess with it. Comes with a cobra, man. Got interchangeable head, interchangeable hands, like they all do. I love that they do that with them. Woo! There goes his nunchucks. Those are pretty cool. Don't want to break them, though. I don't like when they do the wire nunchucks for Michelangelo, like the movie figures. That's what they did for him. They gave him the wire nunchucks. I like when they do the chains like that. It's just got that more real look to it. Take the cobra off. Sorry, buddy. Don't be mad. I got you. There you go. All right. Those are badass, man. Comes with two closed fists. About to punch you. And then he comes with the two holding ones. They're a little bit open, so he can hold his nunchucks. Or the cobra, whatever. And then the hands that he's got on now, kind of the same thing as Raphael. It's like the bridge. See, that's what I'm talking about. Like, I don't know if I want to put that head on there, man. That just, yeah, I'm probably going with that one for sure. The other one that he has on now, it's like closed. His eyes are closed. One of them is. This one, they're like wide open. And look at his teeth, man. So like sinister looking, and it's great. I love it. All right, let's cut this bad boy open. Man, Michelangelo looks cool, man. So the mummy. That's the head that he comes with. It's like one eye open, one eye willy.
Oh wow.
His neck, not where his head's at, but down there below. It's like another separate joint. Man, you can really move that. That's awesome. The detail on them, dude. They always kill it. I love NECA with their figures like that. Okay, see. This kind of shit, this is where I have to heat them up because I always have a problem getting it back on. Oh, but look at that. Yeah, dude, that's so badass. So we are going to give him the open fist hands because I want him holding his nunchucks. I think that will look cool. If you guys don't like it, let me know. Tell me to change it up. I'll change it. We can always go with other looks.
Good.
Yeah, His arms are weird, man. His hands. Like, I could see the joints. They're like
this. They're not like that, you know, like they usually are. They're like this. That's the only way you can move it. Okay. I got it.
That's great.
Oh, yeah. We definitely have to put those on his wrist. That's probably why his hands are like that. Durr. I didn't even think about that. Sorry. But I love it. I love it.
Yeah, let's put him right there.
Right there. Yeah. Michelangelo as the mummy.
All right, all right. Back for another review. Donatello as the Invisible Man by NECA. Yeah. I picked this one up for my brother for his birthday. And this one, this is probably, I'd have to say my favorite one out of all of them. Just the way he looks, all the shit he comes with. He just, dude, he looks so cool. So badass. I really want to dive into this one. Let's check him out. Donatello as the Invisible Man. And the other day, I didn't notice, but like on all, I'm pretty sure it's all the NECA figures. Says on the box, on the bottom, what it all comes with. Everything. Includes gloves, hands, visible feet, extra head, goggles, hat, bow staff, microscope, TGRI journal, beaker, and stirring rod. I mean, and then on the bottom it says everybody that, you know, sculpted the figure, painted, prototypes, photography, directed and designed the figure. I love what they're doing, you know. They're keeping the turtles alive. And the figures that they're coming out with, they're just, they're unbelievable when you look at them. It's like, wow, I can't believe the detail that they put into these guys. But I know some people don't know how to be gentle. Trust me, I'm one of those people. I know. You just gotta be careful, man. You gotta have patience with these figures when you're opening them. A lot of people, that's why they don't, you know, that's the value, but also a lot of people just don't want to mess with them. Yeah, this is probably my favorite figure out of all of them. That's until the Wolfman, Raphael as the Wolfman. I haven't seen him yet. We'll see. Man, holy cow, does he come with a lot. The whole thing of hands and feet for Donatello. He's got his bow staff.
He's got his beaker, stirring rod, TGRI journal, his hat, interchangeable head. Look at that. I like that. I like that head, but this one that he has on now, this is the one where you can put his hat on. I don't know, Leppy, we might put his hat on. He looks like a G. Wow. He actually has a leather strap on, like the holster. Dude. That is detailed as fuck. All right, so he's got closed fist right now, but I don't know, man. It's Donatello. Donatello always looks badass holding his bow staff. He comes with a lot, man. His invisible hands. Dude, I love those. Look at his feet. Invisible feet. Love it. Good. Yeah, I think I'm going to have to give him those invisible feet, too. It's going to look so awesome on him, dude. We have to. Okay, and then he's got his bow staff. That looks great. His other ones, man, the his other bow staffs that I've seen, they're straight, and then at the very tip, it's like, it's terrible. TGRI journal. It's a tongue twister. There you go. Speaker and all that. His head, his hat. Love it. All right, let's get these feet on. We're gonna have to get this bad boy to stand. That's awesome looking. Just look great. I really don't understand why. I mean, I guess it's money, you know? They know how to make their money. But I just don't get why they came out with two different versions of Leonardo, two different versions of Raph. Are we getting two different versions of Donatello and Michelangelo and Splinter and Casey Jones in April that they came out with? I don't know. We don't need that many monster figures, but I guess we do. I heard they want to make more of, like, all different monsters, the Ninja Turtles and shit. I don't know. Damn, it's a lot of money, but it's a cool collection. Looks cool. Especially if you're into that kind of shit. Well, that's him with the normal head. I really don't want to. I don't know. Yeah, I'm going to keep this head. So I like that hat. That hat is pimp shit. Yeah, dude. Oh, wow. Can you put the goggles on him? Holy cow. Yes, you can. Oh, dude. I don't know. That looks cool, too. With his goggles up like that. Right? Yeah, dude. Here, let's get him to stand. Look at that. An invisible shell. You can see the pizza slices in there.
Ah, love it. That looks great. It's Donatello as the Invisible Man by NECA.
Comes with a lot. That I do love. A lot of cool little shit.
Yeah, his journal. Gotta have his journal with him. That is badass. I love it. Yeah, definitely. It's like my top one for the monster line. Hell yeah. Thank you guys for checking out that review. Stay lifted.